Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to group items in the .NET MAUI ListView control. I'll start by showing you how to group items programmatically and create a custom grouping. Then, I'll demonstrate how to sort groups and display a group header summary. Finally, I'll show you multi-level grouping and how to expand and collapse groups as well as group header customization. I am using an example application that has been pre-configured with the MAUI ListView control and data. If you want to know more about creating a MAUI app and configuring the MAUI ListView, you can check the video linked in the YouTube card. Also, you can download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description. Now, I launch the application on an Android emulator. You can see the ListView control rendered with data. First, I will show you how to group items programmatically in the list view. I include the Syncfusion MAUI data source namespace. Next, add the data source and specifies the group descriptors property to accommodate multiple group descriptor definitions. For grouping items by contact type, insert a group descriptor and assign its property name as contact type. To arrange items within each group in ascending order based on contact name, I add sort descriptor and set its property name to contact name. Looking here, the work group is grouped based on the contact type and sorted in ascending order, specifically by the contact names. Next, I'll demonstrate how to customize the appearance of the group header and stick it in the view. For instance, I want to display the group type and item counts in the header. To achieve this, add the group header template with a data template. Within it, include a grid with a two-column definition and assign its background color as light gray. Next, add a label within the grid to showcase the group name and bind its text to binding key. Then, customize its font size, vertical text alignment, and padding. I include another label in the second column to exhibit the item count in a group, binding its text to count. Then, customize its font size, horizontal option, vertical text alignment, and padding. To stick the group header in view, I set the isStickyGroupHeader property to true. Now, you will notice that the group header has been successfully customized and will persistently remain visible until the last item of the group goes out of view. Moreover, as you scroll through a different group, the sticky group header will change its position accordingly. Now, I will show you how to sort groups based on custom logic. To begin with, I create a new class named CustomGroupComparer. That inherits the iComparer interface of the group result type and implements the compare method. Inside this method, check if the count of group X is greater than the count of group Y. If true, return 1. Else check if the count of group X is smaller than the count of group Y. If it is, return -1. Next, navigate to the XAML page to bind the custom group comparer to the group descriptor comparer property. Add custom group comparer to the page resources with the key. Finally, in the group descriptor, I specify the comparer property and assign the custom group comparer to it. Once loaded, you will observe that all the groups are now sorted based on the count of each group, according to the custom logic. Next, let's move on to multi-level grouping. For instance, to group contacts within a group based on the first character of their name. I navigate to the main page CS file. Here, I create a new group descriptor and set its property name to contact name. Additionally, define its key selector and assign the first letter from the contact name to it. Then, I add this group descriptor to the data source group descriptors property. See, the first level group is further subdivided into subgroups based on the initial letter of the contact names. Next, let me demonstrate how to expand and collapse groups programmatically. First, add a horizontal stack layout above the list view to add the two buttons. Inside that, include a button with its clicked event for expanding all the groups. I set the text of this button to expand and customize the margin and width requests. Similarly, add another button with its clicked event for collapsing all the groups and set its text to collapse. Set the desired margin and width request to this button as well. Then, navigate to the event handler method of the expand button. Within this method, call the expand all method. Similarly, in the event handler of the collapse button, I call the collapse all method. Before running the application, remove the code for grouping the contacts based on their names. Once loaded, notice that the group is initially expanded. By clicking the collapse button, you can collapse the group, and by clicking the expand button, you can expand it again. Now, let me show you how to expand only a selected group. First, I add the group expanding event. Now, I navigate to the main page CS file. Here I create a new field of the group result type named expanded group. Afterward, in the event handler method, check if the group count is greater than 0. If it is, create a new variable and store the selected group result in it. Then, check if the group key is not equal to the expanded group key. If it is, using a for each loop, iterate through the groups and verify if the group key is not equal to the key of the other group. If it is, call the collapse group method and pass the other group as a parameter. Then assign the group variable to the expanded group. Finally, call the expand group method and pass the expanded group as a parameter. Navigate to the XAML page to enable the selected group to expand and collapse action. Here, set the allow group expand collapse property to true. Additionally, in the data source, set the auto expand property to false to prevent the automatic expansion of groups. Before running the application, I remove the two buttons and their event handler methods. Once the list view is loaded, you will see that all the groups are collapsed. Now, when you tap on the mobile group, it will expand, and the remaining groups will collapse. Next, I will illustrate how to cancel expand and collapse actions to specific groups. For example, I want to cancel the expand action for the first group and the collapse action for the last group. To achieve this, I add the group collapsing event to handle the collapsing. Then, navigate to this event handler method. Here, check if the selected group is equal to the last group. If it is, I set cancel to true. Now, move to the event handler method for the group expanding event. Remove the existing code within this method. Check if the selected group is the first group. If it is, I set cancel to true. You will observe that all the groups are initially collapsed. Tapping the first group will not cause it to expand. On the other hand, tapping the last group will result in its expansion, and tapping again will not collapse it. The remaining groups will expand and collapse as expected. In this video, I demonstrated how to programmatically group items based on custom logic, sort in groups, display group header summary, implement multi-level grouping, customize group header appearance, and enable groups to expand and collapse. If you want to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.